Good morning and happy Wednesday, everybody. This is Jill with Greenwood Girl Cards, and I'm coming on to do an episode of Woodblock Wonders. That's right. Woodblock stamps that are in my stash that I hate to not use because they are really my first love of crafting. I love, you used to go to the store and you would pick the images based on what the stamp looked like on the front. And these beautiful wood stamps are still one of my favorite things. And part of what I like about it from a card making standpoint is that this gives you your focal point. And so all you have to do is design the background that you're going to use on your card or tag. And so there's something very artistic about them. And then I love to display them in my room. And I put different ones each year up in my room for Christmas. I go through my stamps and I pick and make little displays. So they're just a big part of my stamping love. So this is the one that I used. I don't know if you can read it. It says, "Do you see what I see?" This is still out there a lot. You can see it at various times if you shop any of the, you know, eBay and Mercari and all those. You'll see this one a lot. It's by JRL Design Co. I don't think you can read that very easily. It's hard to read. But there you go. It's called Snow Scene. All right. So that's the one that I pulled out to use. And I use this 7/8 inch gingham ribbon. I use two different types of twine. This one is a Fun Stamper's Journey. This is Dollar Tree, just in case you're wondering where I get mine from. I use this Alterations embossing folder from Tim Holtz, and it just has stars on it. And this is by Ellison, so it's from Sizzix. And then I use this little rounded rectangles stitched die set. I've had this for a long time. I think it might be Lil Inkers back in the day. So shout out to Laura. She was the one who actually was the first designer to concept stitch dies. So she was the creator of those in the industry. These are some rusty jingle bells. And then I used my diamond stickles, one of my favorite glitter glues. And then I used these LOTV DigiShop tags in blue. And someone had asked me, they want to know how to color these in Word. And Word has changed the way it works a little bit. And so I need to figure it out again so I can show you guys. But anyway, I had done these back in the day, and now I just print them out. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I printed it on a linen cardstock from Paper Tray Ink. You can also get it on Amazon, and it's kind of a mid-weight, so like an 80-pound-ish weight, I would say, maybe a little higher. But that's what I used to print it out, and I specifically use the Merry Christmas. Okay, so those are all of the supplies that I used. So I'm going to set those aside, and I'm using the beautiful board that my friend Sherry gave. Royce and the kids and everybody, we're still praying for you guys. And then I'm going to bring out what I created. So I'll show you the two tags that I made. And I did one in kind of a more of a Christmas colored one, and then I did one more in the earth tones, which I really love the earth tones. There's just something about doing kind of these warm, earthy tones that makes me happy. So I did color these with Copic markers. So the image was stamped and cut out and colored with Copics. And I inked with various inks, including, I'll show you the inks I used. I used this classic crumb cake from Stampin' Up. Boy, my ink pad's dirty. Sorry, you guys. And I used some of this rich cocoa from Memento. And then I also used black, I think. Did I stamp them in black? Yeah. And then I used the Memento Tuxedo Black to stamp in. And this is a great ink to use if you're going to color with Copics, if you're wondering what to use. I always use Memento ink. So that is how I did it. And then I colored, I did ink the bases of these tags with the inks that I just showed you. So you can see that I embossed the background of the tag with the hard embossing folder. And then I don't know if you can tell, but I added little bits of stickles to some of the stars. So the whole tag, when you get it, it glimmers. Okay. And it just turned out really cute. This is such a sweet little scene. And you can see the stitching on the rounded rectangle. And then to do the back, I fold the ribbon. I put some hot glue between the two sides, and then I glue the glued piece of ribbon onto the cardstock. And then I thread a button, and I add the button with hot glue. Okay, and so that's how I created this holder. And then I put the twine through, tie it in a knot, and then I added a little tiny LOTV DigiShop tag with the little rusted jingle bell. And so that's how both of these tags were made. They're identical other than the coloring, of course. And I just think they turned out so sweet. I just think this image is very charming. So, and these make, this one I have the twine tied behind the button, which is, I think, really, really sweet. But I wanted to show you how it looks two different ways. So this one, the twine is tied through the top of the button. Okay, so you can do it either way, depending on which way you like best. Okay, so those are my two tags. And that is this episode of Woodblock Wonders. And now I have some happy mail that I get to share with you guys. Okay, so let me set these aside and maybe I'll put them up here. Then you can still kind of see them. I'll go like this. Okay, and I have some happy mail to share. I received a beautiful card from Karen. And Karen is a watcher of my channel, and she wrote a beautiful note to me. And Karen, I loved what you wrote in your card, and my heart goes out to you. This is just such a sweet card, Karen. Karen's a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, and she also runs a card club where she lives. And I love how she made this beautiful card. I love this image, Karen. I'm not sure who this is by. It might be Stampin' Up! And it says hello, and it's this cute little milk can. I love the little cotton and different flowers in here and how she colored it. This is like a piece of Mylar that's been die cut or something. Or maybe it comes this way, and she used that on the card. And then you can see she used a tiled, a really pretty tiled embossing folder. So beautiful, beautiful card, and beautiful sentiments on the inside. So thank you. And then look at what all she sent. So I'm going to pull out her happy mail here and I'll show you what she sent. She sent this sweet little image of Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus and this really neat star. So I can color that up. And then two little angels. Isn't that sweet? So really cute. And then the main thing that she said in her note was that she was sending me this stamp. And this stamp set is called New Little Someone. Okay. And when she saw it, she thought of me. It was one that she had, and she thought I would enjoy it. So it's got a bunny, a little pin, a little set of booties, some handprints, and then two sentiments so you can make cute cards. And this bunny would be so fun for Easter or spring or any time. So I'll enjoy playing with this. Thank you, Karen. And then on top of that, she also made, look, it's my favorite word, joy. We all have to choose joy, you guys. So she did these joy to the world sentiments for me, and then just also plain joys. So aren't those sweet? And I love how she layered the three different colors, so that, you know, she's got that sparkly stuff on there too. I forget what it's called right now, but so really, really cute. And then she even sent me a few more in here that I could just add to a card as a sentiment. So that was really sweet. And then some little buttons and hearts and things, little die cuts. And then she sent two strips of fabric. And this one is little angels and a patriotic theme. And it has little buttons that are sewn. And if you watch Tina's channel, hello, Crafty Bean. Hi, Tina. She and Elise, who's Lisey46, both did cards with fabric. And the neat thing about fabric is you can trim things out and make cards with it, and or even die cut, because I've had a lot of luck die cutting fabric. You can die cut it too, but it's a fun way to make cards, and you just use you know, those adhesive sheets is a great way to adhere them. There's other ways too, but anyway, it's always fun to have little pieces of fabric remnants and stuff that you can use, because there's lots of things you can do with them. Sometimes I even just wrap a belly band of fabric around a gift. And then look at this other one that she sent. This one says guardian angel, and look at how cute this little angel is flying. So these are just so sweet. And then they say guardian angel. So those will make some adorable cards, or however I decide to use this. You can also cut things out and then applique them to towels, or, you know, there's a lot of different things you can do with fabric. So, and then the last thing she sent was this really sweet printable that shows how to use a die set that I was gifted. And it, she says, I saw that you received these dies on one of your shows. I also have them. I made a copy for you. It makes it a lot easier to assemble. So she shows the different ways that you can assemble the die, and it's a printable that she did for me. So that was really sweet of you, Karen. Thank you so much. I still haven't even played with these, but I want to. So I need to do that. But that was so sweet of you to think of me and to bless me with all of these beautiful, beautiful gifts. And of course, your beautiful, beautiful card. This is going to go up on my windowsill so I can look at it all week and just enjoy the beauty of what you created. So thank you for sharing your heart with me and for being so generous and kind with the things that you sent. I will have fun playing with them. So that is it for this episode of Woodblock Wonders. And I hope that you guys all have a wonderful day. Bye now.